I've spent my entire life just about past decades since I was a kid desperate to, wanting to, thinking I could save my mom. I can't save her. That's the thing. I've spent my entire life wanting it. She's not doing good. She's not eating enough. She appears to be sleeping, but she's not eating enough. She's not leaving the house. She didn't have her piano lesson for the past 2 weeks in a row, or going to church the past 2 weeks in a row. And like Joe says, she's trying to avoid people. She knows something's wrong, so she thinks she can postpone the inevitable. The fact is, she's not bad off enough to, you know, but she can't postpone seeing the professionals in her life indefinitely. She can't. And they're the ones that, of course, get taken seriously by the police, whereas I never do. I don't. And she's not bad off enough anyway. There's nothing really I can do. There's nothing anyone can do in this situation. I make sure she takes her meds. I tell her to eat. I can't force her to eat. I'm gonna try to leave today. I'm gonna try, keep being try. I haven't left the house in 2 whole weeks. A little over. I originally planned to give myself 1 week, but then we had horrible weather, and then we had everything happen. This week. Two whole weeks, except to walk Omar periodically. I have not left the house. I went to get the mail a couple times, and I walked Omar a few times. Take Omar outside, or, you know, I'm never again going to put him out on the deck unless there's a ton of snow out there. That way, he's, you know, if he's in snow, he can't topple over the truck, which is heartbreak as hell. I'm going to try to go. There's no guarantee. I don't know. These inserts, I don't like. They're not custom made. I can't afford custom made. Custom made, he got them for $500 because she's been with her podiatrist for decades. I would have to pay $800 or $900. That's what they cost. And I told him that she paid $500 for these perfect, really good custom made inserts. But they're regular, like, 800 and something. Like, it's unreal. And that's what I would pay. Because I don't have an established relationship for decades with a podiatrist. I can't afford that. I can't afford anything at all. I can't afford shit. Shit. She is not doing good. She's like a drowning person. She's like a drowning person who helplessly, she wants to take me down with her. Drowning person can't even help. They wind up a lot of times killing the person trying to save them, because they desperately claw onto them, and then they both drown. She's like a drowning person. She wants to take me down with her. Even if it's not conscious. She wants to take me down with her. And I have to fight with every fucking fiber of my being to not let it happen. Summed it all up perfectly. It's exactly what Joe would say. Exactly. Perfect analogy. She's like a drowning person who helplessly wants to take me down. Not even conscious on her part. And she would deny it. She wouldn't even be able to intellectually process it anyway. And every time I leave the house, that's my secret. I fantasize that something exciting will happen, even though I know nothing exciting is going to happen. I'll be lucky if I can even walk. I'll be lucky. But I always fantasize. That's why I blast my music in my ears. Fantasize that something exciting is going to happen. Nothing exciting ever happens. Not even innocent excitement. Not even like when that cutie pie came up behind me and tapped me on the shoulder when I was walking through Sunset in Hollywood with my suitcase full of Beanie Babies. And I had this idea that I'd be able to sell them on Hollywood Boulevard, and I was dressed in a little dress. It's about the same weight I am now, maybe a little heavier, but you know, I carry it well, and I was dressed in a little mini dress in California, Hollywood, you know, and sneakers, and tapped me on the shoulder. I had to take my Walkman off. I thought he was just asking for directions or something, and he just like, I just wanted to let you know, I think you're adorable. Nothing even like that ever happens, not even when I'm dressed, skimpily dressed in barely any clothing in the summertime, and I look good, you know, nothing ever exciting happens like that, nothing. Fantasize every time I leave the house something exciting is going to happen, even though I know that it's just fantasy.